Hi guys, I'm Barbara and I'm back to review a recent show that I saw at the Barbican, which was the exhibit by visual artist Ito Barrera. The exhibit is titled Agadir, which is a tiny city in Morocco that was devastated by an earthquake in 1960.
I really enjoyed the show. I think it really got to show you the different aspects of rebuilding after destruction. You know, how do you put the pieces back together after your whole life is ripped out from your very hands? But I'll discuss further. First of all, let me tell you what happened when I first walked in.
Okay, so when the show started, I was quite surprised by the level of noise. First of all, I just assumed that it was people being a bit too loud whilst enjoying the exhibit. However, upon some research and some snazzy detective work, I was able to realize that the sound was actually coming from speakers hidden beneath the wicker chairs. I really enjoyed the spin that the artist took on these chairs. You usually associate the divan style in therapy rooms where you feel like it's your chance to get to speak, but here it was all changed. You get to sit down and you have to be quiet and listen to the audio that comes out from the speakers covertly placed around the chair. You get to hear excerpts from the novel / play by Moroccan writer Mohamed Kair Eddine. I think it's quite interesting because you really get to hear from actors in the play that have been affected by the earthquake and how they discuss about rebuilding their lives after such a devastating event. Each chair did not follow along the story. It didn't make sense. These stories didn't really line up together and they're completely different from each other. But that's life after an earthquake. It's chaotic. And that was showed well through the auditory pieces. I think for me that was the most thought-provoking aspect of the show, just being able to sit down and listen. Another aspect of the show was a mural that surrounded the curve, and it was all black and it kind of felt like crayon paintings of the changing architecture in Agadir. So you have some images of some of the buildings that were there before the earthquake struck, and you really get to see how that changed when, you know, the town was rebuilt after the devastating event. And I think the style is very minimalist compared to earlier architecture in the town. I did really enjoy the curation of the show. I enjoyed that the architecture was in a chronological order, so you got to see that transition, that change in creative thinking when it comes to rebuilding the town. Another aspect that I really enjoyed was the pictures and collages, and I think those pictures kind of showed you the struggle there, but now, compared to the mural that showed you kind of the, this is what's happened after. I also really enjoyed the film. I enjoyed the fact that you get to see the effect from people that were there. It showed rudimentary cooking equipment, people living in camps, the search and rescue trying desperately to find more people alive, people's businesses, livelihoods destroyed completely. And I think for me what was evident in the video was the eerie, unsettling stillness, the quietness of what was once a buzzing and vibrant city. Thank you so much, and I hope that you get to see the show and enjoy, and let me know what you think. Thanks, Barbara. I'm out.